Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2006. Okay, so the question is, suppose that it takes 1 unit of time to transmit a packet of a fixed size on a communication network. Okay, so it takes how much time, guys? 1 unit of time to transfer that packet. Okay, the link layer uses a window flow control protocol with a window size of n packets. Each packet consumes an acknowledgement or NAK, that is negative acknowledgement, to be generated by the receiver, and acknowledgement or negative acknowledgement time is negligible. That's really good. Further, the round trip time on the link is equal to n units. Okay, so the round trip time is also equals to n units. Okay, consider that time i is greater than n if only acknowledgements have been received till i, no acknowledgements. Okay, then the good put evaluated at the transmitted at the time in the package per unit time is okay. So what did they give, guys, in the question clearly? Okay, so what did they give? They gave that the time of transmission, that is nothing but the packet transmission time, is a 1 unit time. I don't know in which units they are saying, like it is second or millisecond or what, but we know at least this, right? Yes. And they also told that the window size as a n. Okay, and they also told that round trip time is equals to n units. Okay, so did they say anything, guys? Okay, and they also told one more thing about acknowledgement is that, okay, consider time I is greater than n if only acknowledgements have been received till time I. Okay, so basically we will assume some particular time. Okay, and once that time is out, we will send only one cumulative acknowledgement. So that is what they are saying, I think so. According to my understanding, that is what I am getting. Okay, and they are asking at the end, they are asking the throughput, guys. So what will be the throughput is what they are asking, right? Yes, that is nothing but they are calling it as good put. Okay, yes. Okay, so first let us go through the question once again. So further round trip time on the first link is equal to n. Okay, so with that understanding, I think we can say one thing. So if I send my first packet, at how much time I can expect my first acknowledgement, guys? At n units of time, right? Yes. Or first acknowledgement. Okay. So indirectly, what else did they say? So basically, let us write this statement also. So what did they say there, guys? They told that how much time it will take for that many items, right? Yes. So basically up to i, time total is nothing but I minus n acknowledgements will come, right? So that's what they told, I think so, right? Yes. Okay, so what is a throughput, guys? Throughput is nothing but how much, what is throughput, guys? Throughput or good put? Throughput is nothing but how many successful deliveries you did and how much time you took, right? Yes, so it is nothing but some kind of a ratio, like throughput, how much well you are doing in something, right? Yes, so basically we will compare with how many successful things you did with the time, so how much time you took. Okay, so what is the successful definition in this particular question, guys? So it is nothing but the number of successful receives. So basically in n amount of time, okay, we are going to do I. So consider I is greater than n if only acknowledgements have been received till time I. Got it? Yes. So that will be our successful time, right? Yes. So that is nothing but I minus n. Okay. And the total time or the time which we take. So that normal time is nothing but I units of time, right? Yes. So that is nothing but I minus n by I. Sorry, 1 minus n by I, right? Yes. So that is nothing but option A. Got it? Yes, so it's a quite a different type of question, guys, to be clear, because it's a kind of a confusion type of question, right? Because everything is given in terms of a text. There is no numerical and everything, right? Yes. So now you got some idea, right? So basically here the throughput is nothing but how many things you can do, successful deliveries, by total time taken. Okay, so we have calculated as he clearly gave that the I is the total time, okay, till time t, that will be the total time, and the number of deliveries will depend completely on n, right?
Yes.
So now you got an idea, right? Because why it is dependent on n is because n time of units you will take for first acknowledgement. So basically, if it took 100 nanoseconds or 100 milliseconds and the first n took 10, so indirectly how many we got? Guess we got total 90, right?
Yes.
So in that way, we will be calculating it and we will divide it by the original number of I. So if I is 100, you will get in this. So it is a 0.90, that is a 90% throughput. So in that way, it will work. You got the idea, right?
Yes.
So when the numericals are given, it will be really easy. Like this, we can substitute and we can get the answer. Got it?
Yes.
So I hope everyone got a clear idea. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you.
Thanks for watching.
Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.